Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Nina Ribena's Art Journal Prompts and More. It's week four of this month's Repeat After Me prompt, and the challenge this week is abstract. I want you to create an abstract piece of art. I've created mine already and I'm about to put the video on to fast forward and show you how I did the process. I absolutely love the page that I've created this week, and let me just give you a sneak peek. Ta-da! I just love it so much. It's just gorgeous. And I'll be back with another video early next week, sharing some ideas as to how I would use something like that. Of course, you can interpret it any way you like. These are the paints that I have used. A mixture of De La Rowney and Amsterdam acrylics, red, orange, yellow, ultramarine, blue and turquoise green. I've also used some enamel paints as well, which are very shiny and glossy. And these add some lovely texture to the piece. I've also used some fabric paint in this fluorescent orange, which is absolutely gorgeous, and then some gesso in black and white, just to add contrast to my piece. I've used a mixture of a couple of different stamp sets, which I'll link in the description box below so that you know exactly what I've used, and household items, just packaging and things that I have found around the home to create my piece. So I'll let you listen to some nice music now and enjoy the video, and I'll be back at the end.
Thank you.
So here's my finished page. I just absolutely love how this has turned out. I just think it's gorgeous. I just love all the repetitive geometric shapes. The colours are just gorgeous. I love the shine that using the enamel paint has added. It just gives so much texture. Really, really happy with that. And you saw me working on scrap papers as well, drop papers underneath, and this is what I've ended up with here. This is just all of the leftover paint have gone onto these two pages here. It tore at the beginning of the video, hence the reason I've ended up with two, but I just love them both. And you know, these are perfect for using in collage or, you know, doing lots and lots of things with. Now I will be sharing another video in a few days' time with ideas as to how I plan on using these things. So I'll come back with some ideas there, but I look forward to seeing how everybody else decides to interpret this week's abstract challenge. I'm going to be listing this page on Etsy. If anybody is interested, it will be a downloadable page that you can print out as many times as you like. So, you know, if you're interested, then I'll leave the link to my Etsy shop in the description box below. But as I say, I just look forward to seeing your interpretations. And if you enjoyed that, as always, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up. And let me know what you think in the comments below. Take care, everyone, and I'll see you all again soon. Bye for now.